you consistently outperform your competition. You're actually selling over double the homes that they are. So how do you define your competitive advantage? What are the key elements of your competitive advantage?
Well, I think it all comes, I mean, that's a big question. Wow, how do I attribute my competitive advantage? Well, we've certainly created a bit of a monster machine in the Durham region. We have a well-known brand, without question. But having said that, we can't just rest on our morals. We are moving forward. So we're doing and investing and constantly thinking of what's best and what's next. I know that there's going to be young people coming to this industry. We teach, coach, train them all the time in different marketplaces. I don't teach, coach, train in my own marketplace. But I watch them grow fast, rapidly when they implement my systems, turnkey in their areas. They can't believe the results. So I think the biggest attributing factor to that machine, if you will, or the fact that we continue to dominate, would be the monitoring, tracking, and staying in tune with what's best, what's next, and investing in the business. And that does include training. We are constantly training as teams, as our team members, in every industry. We're constantly dissecting and making sure we're on our game.
And do you also continue your own personal training?
Oh, 100%. Absolutely. As to growth and development, it's massive. I'm constantly looking with, talking with, working with. I've had business coaches myself. I do right now. I'm always looking to grow and expand and make sure my limits are being pushed. I know what my why is. I know why I do what I do. I absolutely love and look forward to the time I spend with my kids and my family, my cottage. I absolutely love it. As a matter of fact, I love it so much that I'll take from Thursday night to, you know, sometimes a Monday night before I even go back to the office quite often. And I look forward to it, but then I make sure when I'm working, I'm doing the things that I have to do to make sure that I'm able to live my life. But yeah, absolutely. A big part of what I do, make sure that I'm not out of sync and out of balance, because it can consume me too. This is a machine, and I could very easily step back on that hamster wheel. Very easily could I get sucked back into just being business Dan and not having a life.
And so how do you find the time to do training? Because you've got multiple, running the business, doing so many things on your plate. How do you even find the time to continue to bring in new voices, new ideas, and to continue to train?
I leverage great people, great technology. Marketing's a big part of it. But the people that I have that teach, coach, and train, my master coaches, are superior in a lot of ways and have done more things in business than I have. A. B, another example would be they've worked in and on the team and understand the systems thoroughly. So there's a lot going on in that question too, excuse me. I think the biggest thing for making sure that the momentum keeps moving forward for me is that we have quality people that have had experiences, that are great at business, that understand what people need specifically. And we've talked about a lot of those things today. So the biggest thing for me is to making sure that I don't get sucked back in, that I'm finding the right people. And it, you know, it's funny, there's a lot of great people available for every different aspect and area. I mean, you gotta pay them well too. You gotta pay people well. You have to pay people well. You have all the best systems in the world. If you don't pay people properly, they're not gonna stay.
There's no retention.
They won't come. Never mind retention, right? So, and pay is a part of retention. It absolutely is. The training, the continued knowledge, qualified leads and opportunities. Again, money's a natural byproduct for them too. The culture and the team members that I have, they know, they believe, they genuinely believe that they don't need to focus on money. Money's a natural byproduct. They focus on the right things, the training, the doing the do every day, the perfect day. Am I getting the life that I want? Am I accomplishing my goals on my vision board? The stuff I want to do. I can't tell you how many times I've had people's parents that I've run into and talked to that work on the team and how happy they are and complimentary they are towards me and the team for where their child is. That's pretty cool, right?
It is.
And it's not just about money. They're living their life too.